Firstly, just to confirm with you that there have been 4 new cases in the past 24 hours alone, taking the total number here in Hong Kong to 104. Now, one is considered to be an imported case. She fell ill at the end of a lengthy visit to India. Now, the Center for Health Protection said that the 69-year-old was in India from January 31st to February 24th and then suffered from diarrhea at the end of her trip. Now, after coming back to Hong Kong, she actually developed a fever and twice consulted a Chinese doctor before visiting an outpatient clinic where she was tested positive for the coronavirus. She took the flight CX694 with Cathay Pacific from New Delhi on February 24th, and passengers on that flight urged to contact the Center for Health Protection hotline. Now, only a handful of COVID-19 infections have been reported in India before this week. The number of cases have actually surged, with the authorities there reporting 22 cases on Wednesday. Two of these 3 other Hong Kong newly confirmed cases linked to a known cluster of infections centered around a small Buddhist temple inside a residential building in North Point. That includes the person in charge of that temple. In all, 18 cases so far have been linked to this temple. The last patient is a wife of a man who had earlier been confirmed with COVID-19. She, along with 2 other cases linked to the temple, did not show any symptoms of the illness earlier. Now, the minister in charge, Home Affairs Minister in charge of the operation to evacuate hundreds of Hong Kong people, have been stranded there in Hubei province for weeks, says that things have progressed smoothly on the first day and that the authorities have successfully brought back 244 people on 2 chartered flights. Now, Mainland Affairs Secretary Patrick Yip told reporters on the tarmac after the second flight on Wednesday night that 3 people had signed up to come back but were actually barred from boarding the flights as they were found to be feverish. He said that officials had made arrangements with mainland authorities to bring those people back when their fevers have died down or whether they've complied with the prevailing arrangements for disease and control. Mr. Nip says that some 200 passengers were evacuated from the province of Wuhan, while 44 others and 20 others came from other provinces and were considered to be an urgent need basis to return to Hong Kong. They included pregnant women, students about to take their secondary school exams, and people with serious medical needs or have scheduled surgeries here in Hong Kong. 9 people also, I should mention, changed their minds before actually taking the chartered flight back.